These are the Pure Stocks now to wrap it up tonight for 20 laps. They go to the green flag this way on the pole. From Mobile is Cameron Latham driving to 34 tonight. Outside of the front row from Mobile, Robert Barber, 97. Second row, the two-time winner from Kushla, Mason Johnston, 06. Outside in the second division Hoopy race tonight, 21 from Satsuma is Butch Harville. Third row inside in the 14, the Billy Hoover car out of Cottondale, Florida. It's Dylan Usery. Outside of that row, the winner last time out from Dauphin Island, 88, Gino Denmark. Back in the fourth row from Pensacola, Dirty 30 is Bobby Suarez. And outside from Saraland, R18, Brad Mosley. Late arrival taking up the tail end of the field from Cantonment, Zach Jordan. 20 laps, Pure Stocks. This is a non-points race. Not originally on the schedule, but our promoter Tim Bryant added them so that they had a place to race this weekend. So the Pure Stocks are going to wrap it up here with 20 laps. Pace car in, looking for a green flag here. 20 laps, Pure Stocks. Here we go. Mason Johnson's the only former winner in this field, and he's a two-time winner. That's 06. Back there racing on the inside in the fourth spot. Outside, Gino Denmark. Started sixth, up to the fourth spot now. That's the 88. Ending the first lap of the Pure Stocks. And it's Robert Barber in charge. From 8 mile 21, Butch Harville is second. Cameron Latham has fallen to fourth, and here comes on the outside, Gino Denmark. Lap two. And Robert Barber continues to lead it here. Harville about a car length behind, and then back a couple of more car lengths, maybe three, is Gino Denmark, who is charged from the sixth spot. Cameron Latham falling from the pole to fourth. Fifth spot belongs to Mason Johnston. He wants fourth under Cameron Latham for that spot. Three complete. Barber's got a couple of car lengths lead now over Butch Harville. And a couple of more car lengths back to the third spot of Gino Denmark. Robert Barber would love to get this thing. I'm not sure he's ever gotten a checkered flag at Five Flags, but he would love for it to be tonight. Gino Denmark looking to make it two in a row. Coming up to third spot, it's a close third now. Battle for fourth spot. Johnston inside. Cameron Latham outside. He's going to lose the spot to Johnston. Five of 20, complete right there. Top three remains the same. Barber, Harville, and Denmark. Mason Johnston has got that four spot all on himself now, but he is a half a straightaway back from that top three battle. Six complete. Back for Mason Johnston, it's Usery. Dylan Usery. From Cottondale, Florida, he heads up the battle for the fifth spot. Cameron Latham has fallen to six behind him. Seven complete on the front straightaway. Still not up to halfway. Gino Denmark takes the opportunity with Butch Harville leaving the inside open. Denmark goes to second spot. Now let's see if Gino Denmark can run down Robert Barber, who's led from the first green flag. Denmark's within a car length now. Butch Harville still in it. A lap some traffic on the back straightaway. Coming to nine complete, not quite halfway. Robert Barber continues in the front. He's had a lot of great finishes, and currently Robert Barber second in the Lloyd's Glass Pure Stock standings. Mason Johnson, the fourth place car, is the point leader, a two-time winner. Well, that's a distant fourth. Genmark looked on the outside of Robert Barber. That didn't work. 10 complete on the front.
Halfway this time, 10 laps down, 10 to go. And our final race of the evening, and look at this battle.
Top three, tail to nose.
I mean, we've been bragging about it all night, Bill, on how tough the competition has been in every division, and look at the top three, nose to tail, Robert Barber, Gino Denmark, Butch Harville.
Non-points in this race, but it's competitive anyway, especially that top three.
Harville falls off the pace just a little bit, but Denmark, he's not going to cut Robert Barber any slack. Oh boy, contact! We stay green! And somehow Barber holds on to the lead. Here comes Harville on the outside.
Well, that action, it made second place be a side-by-side battle between Denmark, and outside of him now is Harville.
Mason Johnson trying to get up there, and that 06 machine, two-time winner this season, trying to close the gap. 13 laps complete, seven to go. Despite the contact on the front stretch, look at these guys. Holy cow, Robert Barber, if he's able to hold on, it will be the performance of the year in this division.
Look at that, tail and nose, and it really is tail and nose as everybody's looking for a lane to get by the driver in front of them.
3 second place finishes in 2023 for Robert Barber.
15 complete here, 5 to go.
Looking for his first win, 5 to go. Barber, Denmark, Harville. Little bit loose for the 97, but Denmark unable to take advantage. 4 laps remaining as they come across the front. What a show in all divisions here tonight. Harville gets a little bit squirmy. He's going to lose touch with the leaders. 3 laps remaining. This time across the stripe. Denmark's holding on to it. That thing is squirmy. But he's got the pedal to the metal. He cannot afford to let that 97 get away from him. This late in the race, Denmark's got to keep it going. He takes a peek to the outside. Oh, the 97 gets loose. Barber trying to hang on to it. Here comes Denmark. 2 to go. Denmark's going to go the long way around. Now to the back straightaway, side by side for the top spot. It's going to come down to the final lap. Barber on the inside. Gino Denmark on the outside. Barber has the advantage on a 4 as the white flag is in the air. What will Denmark do? Will he try the long way? No, he's going to slingshot to the inside. Can he get to the bumper? Barber has the left sides on the apron and 2. It's going to come to the final corners. Barber leading. Denmark trying to get there. Can Barber hold on? Can Barber hold on? He does. Robert Barber wins the Lloyd's Glass feature race. Holy cow. What a show. All night tonight in all divisions. And Robert Barber comes away with his first win at Five Flag Speedway. Don't forget, fans, coming up in 2 weeks, Friday, June 2nd, Kid Bicycle Races, If you've got a youngster, all they need is to bring their bike and helmet. We've got age divisions, trophies, and free ice cream for everybody, for all the kids. That's coming up in 2 weeks, Friday, June 6th, here at the famed Half Mile Oval. We've gotten our fair share of burnouts here tonight. Lots of celebrating. Lots of first-time winners. What a show by Robert Barber. So Barbara will bring it to the Michaels and Booth Accident and Injury Lawyers. Victory Lane, after 3 second place finishes this season alone, Robert Barber gets it done. Let's send it trackside to Bill Roth, who's waiting for our winner.
There's a happy group down here for this driver from Mobile 97, just about ready to get out of the car. Here he is, Robert Barber, big win in 97. And he's going to get stuck getting out. All right. Hey, Robert Barber, welcome to Victory Lane at Five Flag Speedway, bud.
Thank you. Gene was giving me a run there, but I'm glad to say you don't have to have a Dewey Miller motor to outrun him.
It's smoking a little bit here, but first checkered flag at Five Flags, right?
Yes, sir. I got to thank the Langham Bunch, Mater, Oki, everybody that's helped out on this thing. Loper's Tires, my wife, my mom. Everybody. And then we got 1-2 from the shop of Langham Motorsports.
And here comes third place, Butch Harville. So look, I doubt you've got a motor or tires left after that burnout. I want to point something out to you here. I will. What's that? That's a worn out tire, isn't it?
Yeah, I had to redo it because I got black flagged at the Derby, so I had to redo my burnout right there.
Robert Barber gets the win, his first ever at Five Flags. Are we done, or you got more Victory Lane stuff to say?
That's it.
He's done. Robert Barber gets his first win ever at Five Flags Speedway. So, he hates working on race cars, but I caught him working on this race car in the pits. I thought it was going to be 2 in a row, Geno Denmark, but that's a fast guy there.
Man, I tell you what, I gave it everything I could, man. He drove the crap out of that thing. This here's for Jeremy Bodie. He had a heart attack this morning. And I know you're watching, buddy. We're with you. We'll get you back out here. The 44 is going to be here tonight, but just couldn't make it happen. But thankful he's okay. Yeah, and I got to thank my sponsors, Johnny East, Dewey Miller's Competition Head Service, Patriot Marketing and Media Marketing Services. They're new.
There you go.
I thank them a lot, though.
All right, get well soon, Jeremy Bodie. Second place, fine run for Geno Denmark. Just back this year after many years of not racing. Seemed like everybody in this division likes each other. This guy's been doing this for a long time. Butch Harville, that's as good as I've ever seen you run.
Yeah, we have worked our tails off this year. I mean, we've been fighting this thing for years. My father-in-law, Jimbo, Chris, Oki, Mason, Robert, all the guys that helped get me, just helped me. My dad, my sponsors, Uncle Henry's Grocery Corn and Peanuts, Southport Towing, Mr. Transmission and Mobile, Mac Broke Automotive, MMJ Racing, Circle T Design, F&S Towing, Bed Good Heating and Air, Hey, just keep helping. Keep helping. We're going to work on it some more. We'll be back in 2 weeks, and we're going to tighten it up a little bit this time.
Pretty emotional down here. Butch Harville with a fine third-place finish in the Lloyd's Glass Pure Stocks. That's it, folks. Thanks for coming. We'll be back in 2 weeks. Remember, on your way home, speed is for the speedway, not for the highway. Good night, Debbie, and good night, everybody.